Welcome back to Sochi. We're about to be joining the action down in the pit lane as the cars get ready to embark on their qualifying runs. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Lots of low-speed exits means the rears are in for a lot of punishment. It's all too easy to spin them up coming out of a corner too aggressively. It might look great for us as spectators, as we love to see a car driven beyond its limits, but it's not going to result in a great long-run pace.
Wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. A Red Bull, Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. Good afternoon from Sochi as we prepare to get underway for the Russian Grand Prix. The championship battle has some time to go yet, but still expect no quarter to be given here on this circuit that made its debut in 2014 and has already seen some classic racing. Built on the shores of the Black Sea, the Sochi Autodrome is a 3.6-mile tour around some of the venues built for the 2014 Winter Olympic Games. Close barriers may make overtakes more challenging, but with 56% of the lap taken absolutely flat out, we certainly won't be wanting for pure speed. A fitting arena then to do battle at the pinnacle of motorsport. A tough race in store then for our drivers today, so tell me, Anthony Davidson, what will you be looking out for as the cars make their way down into turn one?
Well, first of all, let's hope that everyone's well behaved and we can have a nice incident-free start. That initial release is going to be the most interesting thing. The clean side of the grid will be better rubbered in, so keep an eye out for cars over there potentially making their way through.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's Red Bull in pole position then, with Nico Rosberg alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Sebastian Vettel, and Alonso, Raikkonen, Sainz, Bottas, and Daniel Kvyat, Hülkenberg, Button, Felipe Massa, and Gutierrez, Perez, Grosjean, Kevin Magnussen, and Pascal Wehrlein, Harry Anto and Palmer, Felipe Nasser and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Thank you.
another fantastic victory for Red Bull today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And I can see now the drivers are making their way out. We need Red Bull fighting at the front. They do an incredible amount for Formula One. And that's another winner's trophy heading back to Milton Keynes. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Our current points leader extends their lead at the top of the championship after a very good result here today. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Kevin Magnussen. That was a commanding performance today, very impressive indeed.
On to the constructors then. Red Bull have extended their lead over the championship. Meanwhile, Renault move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time. You